Hello and welcome. My name is Elliot, and today I am here to show you how you can save time by taking advantage of data entry shortcuts when entering transaction and client information into Tabs 3. The best way to show you is to provide an example in various areas of the software. Keep in mind that these shortcuts are not limited to just those areas, but can be used anywhere in Tabs 3. In the fee file, we're going to cover a few keyboard shortcuts, like starting and saving a new record, as well as using auto text expansion macros. Then in the cost file, we'll take a look at time-saving tips for date and amount fields, as well as options in the description memo field. And then finally, in the client file, we'll show off an easy way to timestamp notes in memo fields, as well as look at other special field behaviors, such as launching an email. So let's get started by adding a fee. Once the fee file is open, you can start a new fee by clicking the New button on the toolbar or by simply pressing Ctrl N on your keyboard. The new fee is opened with your most recent client and reference already specified. From here, you can use the Tab key to navigate through the rest of the entry. Once the Hours Worked field is filled in, you can continue to tab to the Description field, which you can see the T code is pre-filled with starting text. You can utilize text macros to speed up data entry by automatically expanding commonly used words or phrases. And since every firm operates differently, text macros can be customized and added to fit your firm's needs using text macro maintenance. When enabled, macros can be used in any description or memo type field throughout Tabs 3. For example, to finish the description of communicate with, you can enter the text macro OC, which expands to the phrase opposing counsel. Because the rate and fee amount are calculated based on your client settings, you can use the keystroke Ctrl S to save the fee instead of having to use your mouse to click the Save button on the toolbar. Let's switch on over to cost entry. While entering or editing transactions, you may need to change the date. Simply use the arrow keys to move the date backward or forward one day at a time, making it easy to quickly select the date that you want. Another helpful tool that can be used in amount fields is the calculator feature. Let's say that for one of your clients, you want to bill them for multiple external copying charges as one expense, but have separate receipt amounts for each print job. You can use the amount field as a calculator to add up the charges without having to enter multiple costs for the same type of cost. Just use the plus key on your keyboard between amounts, and Tabs 3 will add up the total for you. In the description, let's say you want to list the dates of each service and what was printed on that day. However, you only want to track this for internal reference. Using the Statement Comments feature, you can enter that information in the description field without displaying it on the client's invoice. Statement Comments can be used by highlighting the text, right-clicking in the description field, and selecting Statement Comment from the menu, or by pressing Ctrl H. You can use the right-click menu in any field to determine what shortcuts are available for that field. The client will only see the black text, while you can track the red text for internal use. On a draft statement, the statement comments are printed with strike-through characters, but they're not included on the final statement. Once you're finished entering the description, press Ctrl S to save the record. Another popular shortcut is adding a date stamp to any memo field using the F5 key on your keyboard. Let's take a look at how this can be used in client information. On the Billing Preferences tab, let's add a new note to Billing Notes and Instructions, indicating that the client is requested to be billed quarterly instead of monthly. Press F5 to insert the current date, time, and user so that everyone will be able to see when this update was added. This can be extremely helpful for firms who want to keep track of changing billing procedures or for anyone who wants to better track when information is added or edited. When entering client information, there are a lot of tabs that include different details about the matter. Certain fields, such as phone and email fields shown here, have buttons that trigger an action, such as timing a phone call or starting an email with the client's email address pre-filled, which can be very useful for quickly recording and communicating with your clients. These are just a few of the helpful shortcuts in the software. When you're ready for more time-saving techniques, check out our help topics by pressing F1 on your keyboard or by clicking on the question mark icon in the toolbar for more information about different shortcuts and special field properties. Although we only focused on Tabs 3 billing for this video, all of these data entry shortcuts can be used throughout Practice Master and Tabs 3 Financials. Thank you for watching. See you next time.